What's up, YouTube? It is your friend Ojama Garrett back with a special how-to, and this is something that I have practiced very much in my life, and I'm very proficient at. And I figured I should give the people what they want, and this is a tutorial on how to chug. And before we get into it, I want to play my favorite game, and that is drink till I finish. And so I got my 16-ouncer here. Filled up, and pretty much, you know, I'll go grab a drink and then drink till I'm done. All right, cool. Now that we got that out of the way, let us jump right into the tutorial. How to chug. No, I'm not going to really structure this. It's not step one, step two, step three. I'm just going to try to just throw all the tips I got out there. So my first tip is, of course, to just try to chug a lot volume. Or, yeah, you know what I mean? Like, you just need to drink a chug. If you want to chug, you should just practice it. You just got to practice it and deal with everything. Milk, like when I first started trying, I would just try to drink everything as fast as I can. That would include like milk, water, soda, beer. I mean, before I had to stop liquor, but whatever it was, you just kept doing it, and then all the secrets were then revealed to me. So then I want to, the first tip is drink from the right glass. Drink from the right container. Now, there's a fastest way to chug with every container. Like, for instance, let's say a can. If you want to drink fast from a can, you can punch a hole in the top with your thumb, like, take the mouth, and then just, like, press that tab. Grab the tab really hard. This might cut yourself, but you can press the tab really hard and open the mouth up so that you have a bigger spout so you can dump better. A bottle, I got a couple ways we can throw those back, but we'll get to those. But if you got an optimal choice of you want to try to chug fast, if you're going for an optimal choice, then a 16-ouncer Red Solo is going to be a very good pick because it has a nice big wide mouth for you to throw it back on. So with the right container, the next thing I would say is to drink, or don't chug cold. If you drink a cold beverage, especially a carbonated one, it's going to hit the back of your throat and it's going to trigger your gag reflex more. Like, that coldness is going to cause your throat to close up, so then you'll have a really hard time trying to get a good chug up. So, like, your preferable, like, it's kind of nasty, but your preferable chug, if you're trying to look cool, is to just chug a lukewarm beer. If somebody's trying to, like, rush you, just, like, keep stalling them until you can just, like, really keep your hand on that beer and just really warm it up. Keep it on your chest, whatever, you know, hold it, you know, get distracted, go smoke a cigarette, do whatever it takes to bring the beer temperature up so that you can chug it better. Or just leave them out on the counter. So if somebody wants to have a chug or whatever, you know, has like a party thing or whatever, just go grab one from the counter beer instead of your fridge beer or whatever. Another tip then is to open your throat. And like, I don't know how to really explain this too much because it just kind of came to me when I was doing it more. But like, when you take the cup and you throw it back, and the liquid's just going to hit the back of your throat. Instead of like swallowing or gulping, you just like, I don't know, your throat just goes, and then you just like kind of pour it down your throat. And then like the more you do it, the more it's just going to open up. So just open up your throat. And that brings us, you know, to the other thing. Don't gulp. When you're drinking beer, don't gulp it. Don't gulp, don't sip. You got to be able to open your mouth big and wide. That cup's got to be in there. You got to almost eat the cup. So, like, when you go to pour it back, like this, you know, it's not just like a... Nope, you got to, like, stuff that motherfucker in your mouth.
so that it, like, you have, like, the biggest, the widest part of, like, the most of that circle of that cup just in your mouth, so that you can get, like, an optimal chug. So then, let's see. We eat the cup, we don't gulp, we open up our throat, don't chug cold beverages, drink from the right container. Breathing out. So, like, when you're about to chug,
I kind of, like, bend over. I, like, lean into it a little bit so that I can, like... And then you always chug off and exhale. If, like, you got a breath... If you're in the middle of a breath, you're just going to, like, get... There's a higher chance that you're going to, like,
get an air bubble or choke or just anything that triggers your gag reflex and the chug is over, you know? That's pretty much how it's going to break down. If you trigger the gag reflex, pretty much your chug is over, okay?
So, right. You need to take an exhale. Chug after an exhale.
Then, so right. So, you know, you just go.
And I always try to, like, breathe out everything. So that, like, also when I'm doing that, if I, like, empty my lungs out as much as possible, like more than a normal breath, just keep breathing out and then just...
When you go to throw it back, if you actually start exhaling, then your throat opens up. You know what I mean?
Why is my face this way?
Whatever, who cares? I guess you don't need my face, but your throat will just open up. If you just... You're opening up your diaphragm, you got all that room, and you can really just throw it back.
I think that covers pretty much cups, though. Let me just check my notes real quick.
Yeah, don't chug sitting. That's tough. That's what I did here in the chair. It's really uncomfortable, but don't chug sitting. You want to stand. You want to stand for a chug. And then, like, don't try not to freak out. All right, so then if you chug, this is just tips. If you chug beer, you need to, like, hydrate because it's going to hit you like a truck. If you chug beer, it's going to hit you fast. So you need to, like, what I used to do is, like, for every beer I drink, I try to drink a glass of water in between, or just every once in a while just go to the sink and just throw a bunch back. Just whatever I think about it, just to kind of, like, mitigate it. Water it down more so it doesn't hit you as fast or as hard. And then, like, right after you're done chugging, burp. And then just kind of, you gotta, like, and chill. Like, don't do anything. Don't move around, because, like, when you pour that beer down, that's starting to remind me more tips, because it was water. If I had beer in front of me, this would be easier. But when you start throwing that beer back and it's in your stomach, man, then, have you ever, like, poured a beer bat? Like, it's a nice crisp liquid until it hits that cup and all of a sudden it just fills up with foam. That happens every single chug when you chug it. It goes down into your stomach as a liquid, but then all the foam expands there and then you gotta burp it all out. And if you move around and you twist your body and stuff like that, you're gonna be shooting foam rockets out of your nose and out of your mouth and stuff. So you gotta be aware. Like, when you chug whatever and you're gonna get that watery mouth feeling, just swallow, burp, swallow, burp, whatever. Just chill. Burp and chill. Just... wait it out. It'll take a while. But if you puke in front of everyone, then you're a huge bitch. So you can't do that. Or just do it, whatever. It's fine. I don't really care. I stopped caring. But yeah. So that beer, when it comes down to, like, pouring a beer, if you have... You got to look that up yourself. I don't have any beer to show you, but, like, you want to pour it a specific way. You pretty much pour it down the side of the glass really slowly so that the you're trying to avoid any foam in the cup. So that if you do get foam, you can take the sweat off your nose or off the face right below your eye and then just start, like, dipping it into the bubbles. And the oil in your face will pop all the bubbles in the foam. And then you can do that. And then it takes a little bit. Sometimes it takes, like, 30 seconds to a couple minutes, but it'll just, like, delete all the foam. It all really depends. So, yeah, there's that. All right. That's cups. And then the little bit I wanted to talk about was bottles. Bottles are a fun one, too. Sometimes you only got a bottle. You got a bottle. Small mouth, okay? It's tough to drink. This shouldn't take too long to explain. And, like, it is going to be shooting a bunch of air at the back of your throat. So it makes it, like, considerably harder to chug. Plus, the mouth is super small. So if you're a bottle, you're never going to beat somebody who's drinking a cup unless you have a bendy straw. I don't know, maybe people who drink a lot know about this, but you can essentially to use this straw to force all of the air out of the straw, and then something happens with the pressure from that happening that the liquid just like shoots down your throat like a beer bong, pretty much. And I call it beer shot. And but there is a technique with drinking bottles that you can drink them relatively fast, and that's so you don't want to like close your, you don't want to close your mouth all the way around the beer. You want to rest it on your like kind of on your teeth, but like you, it's gonna look weird. Sorry, let me pull myself up so I can show you guys this. Like your mouth's gotta be like this. So the mouth of the beer is gonna sit right here. And pretty much what you're doing there is you're allowing air to come out the sides of the bottle. You're still gonna have the bubbles and stuff swirling inside of the bottle, and that's gonna restrict flow. But at least it's not going to be all that turbulence coming down your into your mouth, into your throat, and then causing a bunch of like expansions in your throat. So it's not gonna be uncomfortable. And it's going to allow you to just let gravity do the work instead of you having to gulp at all. We're trying to avoid gulping. Now, I'll just kind of show you here. I'm not going to slam the whole thing because like my intro took a bunch of takes and now my stomach's full of water and I still want to have room for this beer shot. But so like kind of like this. Maybe I'll do the whole thing, but yeah. Always exhale, ready? Now it's all gone. Okay. Now we got the grand finale here. So how this works is that you're going to, you need to form a perfect suction around this. So pretty much like when you go to do it, you want to like start hunched over it. You can't like start pouring until you have the perfect seal. So you pull the straw down and then you like form the perfect seal around the mouth. Like kind of like you're gonna. Once you have that seal, you need to like press your lips super tight around the seal because the liquid's gonna try to like push past your lips. And then you just like get ready for it because it's gonna, once it starts going into your mouth, then it really flies. But I'm gonna cut and wait for my stomach to calm down a little bit before I come back to this. All right, so here we go. Hopefully my camera doesn't lag out, but we'll throw it back. I haven't done one of these in a long time. This could be really uncomfortable, probably. And as you can see, it just it flies down your throat. But yeah, I mean, like, that's all I got. I mean, there's, like, I could go on to the nuances of beer bonging because, like, I guess the only thing I don't want to do a beer bong. I don't want to go buy one to show you. But you could apply all those methods to a beer bong, too. But also, once you get super comfortable with chugging, I found that, like, if I have a beer bong, I can actually, like, when you start the flow, you can then also add in sucking and then finish a beer bong faster than gravity can send it. But that's kind of a hit or miss. I haven't done that in forever, probably like 10 years. But yeah, hopefully, you know, you like that. You got something out of it. My webcam lagged out again. I think my computer's about to die, but, this was how to chug. And then, yeah, that was fun. Cool. See you later. Have a good day.